SOMO and the India Committee of the Netherlands have conducted research into labor practices at a number of Indian manufacturers of textile and clothing. These Indian factories produce for a large group of American and European brands and retailers, which include, for example, Bestseller, C&A, Inditex, Tommy Hilfiger and Primark. We have found several labor rights violations and violations of local labor laws, which include bonded labor, child labor, restricted freedom of movement, excessive overtime, wages below the legally set minimum, no freedom of organizing, and unhealthy working environment. And what is of particular concern to us is that the workers are employed under an employment scheme known as the Sumangali scheme. The Sumangali scheme is an employment scheme under which girls are recruited to work in the spinning mills and garment factories in Tamil Nadu. Most of the Sumangali workers are aged between 14 and 21, but some of them are even younger. And the biggest attraction is that they will receive a lump sum payment ranging between 30,000 and 50,000 rupees, meaning between around 400 and 800 euros, after the scheme period has ended. The girls come from poor families. Most of the times they did not have the opportunity to finish their school. For them, in order to get married, they need to find a way to save up this dowry. So the picture that is painted to them by the recruiters is very promising. In many cases, it turns out that the girls can't get married because they did not receive the lump sum amount or because they have fallen severely ill during their time at the factory. The Sumangali scheme is a form of bonded labor because part of the girls' wages are withheld and only paid out after they have completed the scheme period, which means that they are in fact forced to stay with the factory for 3 years, sometimes even 5 years, in order to get their wages. In many occasions, if girls decide to leave earlier, they did not receive the promised lump sum or even part of the promised lump sum. The girls are made to work very long hours. A regular working day consists of 12 hours, 6 days a week. During production peaks, they are even made to work longer, 16 hours or even more. The working environment is very unhealthy. In the spinning area, it is hot and it's humid. There's a lot of cotton dust flowing around. Most of the Sumangali workers stay in dormitories, either on the factory grounds or outside of the factory. These dormitories are always guarded by wardens, and the girls are not allowed to freely leave these dormitories. The workers are not allowed to organize themselves, and trade unions are not allowed to enter the factories. The Sumangali girls are only allowed to make phone calls with their parents. There will always be a guard inside of the room overhearing what they talk about. So the girls feel that they cannot express their feelings out of fear of getting into trouble for it. SOMO and ICN believe that brands and retailers have a responsibility to ensure decent working conditions within their supply chain. It's important that brands conduct audits not only in the units that make the final product, but also in the units that make parts of the final product, such as the spinning and the weaving. If labor rights violations are found, a company should take all reasonable steps to remediate the situation. In order to gain leverage, they should work together with other brands, and they should work together with local stakeholders, government, NGOs and trade unions, as we say, in a multi-stakeholder setting. SOMO and ICN will continue to do research on this issue and will monitor actions and initiatives taken by companies.